Hello again, and today I'm going to show you a game that unfortunately did not come out for the TurboGrafx domestically. That game today you probably would be familiar with, and that would be Street Fighter II Champion Edition. Now this game here was only released in Japan for the PC Engine, and was the largest HuCard that you could purchase in terms of its size. Just by comparison, I have the original Keith Courage or Watoru for the TurboGrafx 16 here, and this would be the HuCard for Street Fighter. If you notice, they are the same as far as their dimensions go, but when I place them on their side here, I'll actually stack them. There's this little bump on top there on the Street Fighter version. This game here was rated at 20 megs, where a lot of PC Engine games were barely making 4 megs as far as the size goes. So just to show you a comparison as far as how much more memory this game had in comparison to other HuCards that had been released for the TurboGrafx and the PC Engine. The only other thing I could say is that Raiden Trad had a six megabit size, but that would be the largest that I've seen other than at this particular title here. For those of you that don't know about Street Fighter, it was a really popular game in the arcades. Quite similar to the success that Pac-Man had before its time. This game everybody knew around the world. As far as this version went, this was the second version of Street Fighter II that was released, and it featured the original 8 World Warriors, which were in the first Street Fighter II game, but also let you play as the boss characters. And on top of that, it also had a feature where you could play as the same player in versus mode against another player to settle a lot of disputes as far as who was the better player and whatnot. The earlier games would only let you play as one character per screen, so to speak. But yeah, let's take a look at this. If you notice here, there's also another place for a HuCard here. This game was actually rumored to be a combination of a HuCard and a CD game, and unfortunately when the game was released, from what I was told, there was syncing issues as far as getting the chip to work concurrently with the CD, but I couldn't see why that wouldn't be a huge problem if they just placed the music on the CD and had all the other information on there. I think that would have been a plus for the game. But yeah, in typical PC Engine style here, they have the booklet. Everything was like in CD shape, but yeah, it was in color, as you can see there. There was actually a 6 button controller by Neck Avenue that could be used here. And of course they had the 3 button controller, but it could also be used with the 2 button controller. As far as the 2 button controller went and the 3 button controller, you would use the select button to switch between punches and kicks. If you notice here, there's only 2 buttons on the standard PC Engine pad, but the start button worked as the number 1 button and 2 and 3 basically, as far as the punches and the kicks went. And here, of course, you have the 3 buttons, and you would just switch them off by pressing the select button, similar to the Sega Genesis version. But yeah, it's very vague as far as the booklet goes in terms of the moves and whatnot. If you look at the characters here, all it does is tell you what their moves are and a little brief history of the characters. But in the rear here, this is, I guess you could say, their generalized moves list. They show you how to do the moves, right here, and then they would tell you as well, like what characters could use those moves. So instead of giving you the moves list for each individual character, I mean, it was all localized within these two pages here, which I think was actually pretty cool of them to do. But yeah, this is basically it. It came in a two CD jewel case, basically. And yeah, unfortunately this game was never released here, but during the time where the PC Engine was going downhill, games like this and a lot of Super CD games actually brought the PC Engine back to life. So it was unfortunate that this particular game and a whole bunch of other games never saw the light of day here in the U.S. But then again, the TurboGrafx never reached the same popularity or had the same support as the PC Engine did in Japan. Although they had so many games for this, none of them made it out here because of a lot of third party contracts, and also I do believe NEC had bad relations with their Japanese counterparts. But yeah, I thought this game would be interesting to show, so I'll kick in a gameplay video and show you what it's all about. Thanks again for watching, guys.
And here we have the character select screen. It had the original 8 World Warriors, as well as the boss characters. And on top of that, what made Champion Edition a little bit more appealing was the fact that you could select two of the same character while playing versus mode, which wasn't available on the previous version. If you notice, when we start playing here, the floor does have the three-dimensional effect that it had on the other versions as well. That's actually pretty surprising to see this gameplay like this on the TurboGrafx or the PC systems. The voice is a little bit more crisp, in my opinion at least. But the music, by comparison to the other two versions, sounds a little less like the arcade version. Since the PC Engine had a high color palette for its time, it was 512, it actually could display a lot more colors than the Mega Drive version. That's why, if you notice, it looks a lot more colorful than the Genesis version. This particular version was actually considered better overall than the Sega Genesis version. Big difference I did notice though, if you notice where your wins are tallied up, there's a black bar that goes all the way across, and on top of that, the icons are there regardless. They just fill up with color when you win a round. If you notice up there right now, they're black and white. Now, fortunately, on this version, just like the other versions that came out around its time, this has three bonus stages, but it has the car stage, the barrel stage, but unfortunately it doesn't have the oil drums. It has that that brick bonus stage that everybody was familiar with on the home versions, unfortunately. Let's try this out with another character here.
Round one.
If you notice, his name is Vega on this version. Overseas, they went by the original names, of course. They just switched him around because the M. Bison character, who was originally the boxer overseas, they didn't want him to be mistaken with the actual boxer Mike Tyson, so they switched around the characters where he was M. Bison. Balrog was the boxer, and Vega was the guy with the claw mask. But yeah, if you have the Super NES version, or the Super Famicom version, this particular one ran fairly close to that one, as far as its graphics went, and the way that it played. What's crazy is that this is a 8-bit video game, where the Super NES version was 16-bit, so yeah, with half the power, yeah, they were able to make a game that looked really close to the Super NES version. Here we have a mirror match where this wasn't available on the original version of Street Fighter 2. You couldn't select two of the same character, I guess for added realism, so to speak. Unfortunately, on this version here, if you notice Mega Drive and the Super Famicom versions, they had Champion Edition, or Normal Mode, and then they had Turbo Mode. This one here would only have Champion Edition. It didn't have the added Turbo Mode. But this was the only version of Street Fighter 2 that was released for the PC Engine. Just to show you again, Balrog was Vega, Vega was M. Bison, Sagat remained the same, but M. Bison was Balrog. Yeah, again, it was an issue of the boxer's name when they brought it here stateside, so they wanted to change that up. Classic battle here. That was one thing with the Street Fighter series, it was far crazy. Yeah, but that'll be my review of Street Fighter 2 Champion Edition, or Street Fighter Dash, as some people knew it as. Thanks again for watching, guys, and I'll talk to you next time.